impulsive, and we do things without even giving thought to it. But the Bible tells us that we should always seek the counsel, and we should always seek the Lord so that He knows how to direct our paths. See, David understands that when he said, listen, I know that my God is the one who will able to deliver me when he went up against Goliath, because he sought the Lord. So the one thing that Moses did not do was he did not seek counsel with the Lord. So fast forward a few years later, 40 years to be exact, we find that Moses has ended up in Midian, and Moses is working for the prince of Midian. And I say that with a little bit of tongue-in-cheek, because I know that our bishop here always considered himself to be the prince of Midian because he has so many women in this church. So Moses ends up in Midian, and he is working for the prince of Midian, who gives him Zipporah to be his wife. Moses,
Jesus. You should take a page out of Bishop's book, brothers. You should take a page out of Bishop's book. But he does refer to himself as being the prince of Midian. So Moses, to get back to the point. Moses goes to work for the prince of Midian. And he's given Zipporah as his wife. And as fate would have it, Moses is living in Midian. And that's what happens sometimes, man. When you're rejected sometimes, you end up in places that God had not set aside for you. It's important to understand that when you follow the leading of the Lord, and that is why Bishop wanted us to continue this teaching here, because rejection is a very strong thing. And I think men handle rejection in a way that is different from women. Men will handle rejection in a way and they will just disappear. And I think that is what Bishop was just alluding to a while ago. So we have to understand how to handle rejection in such a way that it does not destroy our future. It's important to ensure that as a man you maintain some integrity. But we try to do it by ourselves. We are doing all by ourselves sometimes. But we must learn to trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord and lean not on our own understanding. Because I can tell you, Moses thought that he had it all. Moses thought that he had gone to the best schools. He thought he could make the best decisions as far as it relates to delivering the people. But what he failed to realize that God's business requires a divine intervention. God's business does not require a fleshy outlook. God's business requires that you seek Him so that He can lead you and guide you into all righteousness. So Moses ends up in Midian, and sometimes what happens, you know, is you spend so much time in Midian, and that's not where God wants you to be. So God has him for 40 years living in Midian, and then he came to himself and realized that this is not where God wanted him to be. But God needed to teach him a lesson, and the lesson that God needed to teach him was that he needed to humble himself and to submit himself unto the principles of God. You see, folks, I'm telling you right now, if you learn to submit yourself to the principles of God, then all of his righteousness will be added unto you. So Moses is living with the prince of Midian. And one day, he happens to go by this burning bush. The Bible tells us that the angel of the Lord appeared unto him. And Moses saw the burning bush, and out of curiosity, he decides to go over and look at what was happening. Moses had never turned aside before. When he was witnessing the Egyptian beating the Hebrews, he didn't turn aside, he didn't inquire. He just acted out of impulse. But that's what 40 years of living in Midian will do to you. It will cause you, Bishop, to be a little bit more humble. It will cause you, as we say in Jamaica, to take stock of what's going on around you. So here he comes upon this burning bush and he inquires. And I'm told that the voice of the Lord said, Moses, Moses, take off that shoe because the ground you stand on is holy ground. Yeah. Folks, I'm telling you that sometimes what you need in your life, you need to have a burning bush experience so that the rejection that you have gone through can be turned into something that God wants you to be. You can't still, you cannot stand still in your rejection. You've got to do something else. So God said unto Moses, Moses, this is what I want you to do. I want you to go down to Egypt and I want you to deliver a message to Pharaoh. You know what I like about this story? Normally, Bishop, when you're rejected by folks, the first thing you want to do is go to the people who rejected you. But God wouldn't care about the rejection that Moses had been succumbed to. He sent him to the source of the problem and he said, I want you to go to Pharaoh. I'm not going to focus on the rejection. And so sometimes as men, we tend to focus more on the rejection than the real issue. But there's a deeper issue here that you've got to get to. So God said, go to Pharaoh. Don't worry about the rejection that you have just been through. I'll take care of that part of it. You see, Moses liked to take care of the things himself. So God had to somehow delineate who was going to do what. God just needed a mouthpiece, if you would. And Moses was the mouthpiece.